Assalamu alaikum students, this is your science teacher Sabika. I hope you're all doing great at home. Well, in today's video, we're going to talk about eyes in sync, which is on page number 60 and 61. In this chapter, we are going to talk about how we are able to see things with the help of our eyes. But before we get into the chapter, I would like to appreciate all the students who have sent me their homework through WhatsApp. And I would like you to keep sending me your homework on regular basis. With today's chapter, I have also attached a worksheet in the WhatsApp group, and I would like to get the homework within the next 2 days so that we will be able to complete our syllabus in time. With that, let's begin the chapter. Well, in the previous chapter, we talked about different light sources and how the light is produced through different light sources and what are the different important properties of light. But in this chapter, we are going to talk about how the light helps us to see things. Now, one thing that we all know is that light is most important thing needed in order to see the things. Now, light allows us to see things that produce light and also the things which do not produce light. But those things which do not produce the light can be seen through their reflection of light. Now, what is reflection of light? When the light source produces light, it falls on different things, it actually scatters in all direction and it falls on the things, and those things bounce off the light in other directions. In this way, like I drew with this blue pen. Now, when the light is reflected, some of the rays when fall into the eye, that's how we get to see that thing which bounces the light off. Now, for example, if the light source is sun, and it falls on the grass, the light would be scattered in so many different directions. Anybody standing over the grass or standing where he would be able to see the grass would catch the light into his eyes, and that's how he will be able to see the grass. Okay, in the first two paragraphs, a very interesting information has been shared. A question has been raised that can cats and owls see in the dark? Well, common people, most of the people think that the cats and owls can see in the dark. But the fact is that they actually cannot see in the dark. They do have better eyes than us. They have better sight than us. But still, the light is needed in order to see the things. For example, there are nocturnal animals like owls. They hunt at night and they need more light in order to they need light in order to see the things. Now, moonlight is enough for the owl to see, but it's not enough for us to see clearly. Now, coming to the most important part of the chapter, that is eye. In this topic, we are going to talk about what are the internal structures of the eye, what are the parts of the eye which are performing different functions in order for us to see things. Now, the most important parts are pupil, iris, lens, retina, and optic nerve. Now, pupil is the dark circle within the eye, in the center of the eye, which lets the light in.